Hello, ladies and gents, and welcome back to my wee let's play of Doom 3, Resurrection of Evil. From where we last left off, we successfully went through level 1 of the Erebus dig site, where we picked up the artifact and encountered, like, new and familiar foes like the imps and the forgotten ones. Now we're into the second level, the Erebus dig site, where we have to continue finding our way out there and find out what the artifact is about. Anyway, we're still from where we left off. On this lift up there, we're gonna go through this part here. Oh, some of the new bizarre creatures here. They're not making a sound. Oh. Good thing they didn't know we're here. Anyway, we all know this game is actually set 2 years after the events of Doom 3. Anyway, in my last video, I forgot to tell you about the recent depths of famed actors like Michael Farrer, who I known as Shan Yu in Disney's Mulan, and it was John Hurt, who I've known as the Horned King in the Black Cauldron, and Mr. Ollivander in the Harry Potter films, and Bill Paxton, who I've known as some astronaut in Apollo 13, and in Titanic and Thunderbirds, the movie. I mean, I'll probably do them. I'll talk about more about them in the next video. Hopefully. We've got the grenades back. And yes, the artifact is still completely useless at the moment. You see here, I've still got the armor mounted flashlight that you remember seeing in we Let's Play of Doom 3 and in my Let's Play of The Lost Mission. Oh. Let's have a look, see what's up. Huh? Let's talk to this guy.
UAC has no idea what they're up against. They sent us here to die like the others. It killed everyone before we even knew what happened. We couldn't even see it. It moves so fast. No, I won't go back. No, it's still there.
Gee, he's scared of all the recent activities going on.
Go and attract them. Get the hell away from me!
Okay. Stay there to hide like a coward for all I care. Okay, let's have a look at the PDA for a while. Let's see, excavation anomalies.
Audio log from Marcus Tanner, team coordinator. Oh, we shouldn't be here. I don't think we... This dig site. We've seen structures like this before, represented in tablets sent back to Dr. McNeil. Up until now, we hadn't seen any artifacts in what must have been their original state. There seems to be some sort of defense mechanism in place, attacking those godforsaken creatures. Why did the gate open? The amount of chaos and movement within is new to all of us. All of us that are left. Our team leader didn't make it. Was pinned down by something. What it was, I can't even describe. The best bet is to seal this place up and get the hell out of here. It's happened again. I can't believe it's happened again. Lying bastards. We didn't come here for this. No! No! Ah!
Well, they could have added, like, the sound effects of the imps attacking him, but we heard on that audio log in The Lost Mission. I remember, well, what was that all about? Ah, here's the video about the ionized plasma levitator, or the grabber gun. Let's have a look at that. Got me monologuing.
Union Aerospace is proud to unveil its latest tool to help make safer worlds for everyone. building on field containment experiments in the Delta Labs and the energy production capabilities of the Enpro plant, the prototype ionized plasma levitator was designed to transport hazardous materials without physical contact. By creating a controlled, electromagnetically charged plasma stream, the IPL unit is able to act upon physical objects of light density and transport them between short distances. Initial tests have shown that the IPL unit is also able to act upon charged energy masses, which is vital to modern experiments in manipulating new potential energy sources. With further research and development, uses for this technology would include heavy lifting and the ability to create tractor beams, thereby making low-gravity docking procedures much safer for pilots. For more information, contact the UAC's Advanced Tool Department.
Yeah, oh yeah, I was about to tell you about the main differences of the grabber. I'll think more about that as soon as we get out of here. I hear an imp locking about again. Should be around here right now! I knew that was gonna work. Oh! Oh, you're still doing that routine, eh? See, grab a gun's ideal for grabbing fireballs. Like, on the MC. Uh-oh. This is very useful, and it helps you save more ammo for your other weapons. Oh, come on, look at that! It says 2 against 1! And as always, this isn't fair! Could've always used my shotgun against them. Oh! I'm really closed. Oh, here we go. Oh, look at this guy here. Whoa. Don't come any closer! That I've just killed was a Vulgar. You know, he looks more like... What are you looking at him here? He looks more like Accelerate from Ben 10. And back to the differences of the grabber. We know the grabber here can grab like fire... What you saw there, it can grab like... plasma balls and fireballs and throw them back at the respective enemies. Oh, no, the other, and another main difference with the grabber is it, if you watch here. Yep, you can see here, it really doesn't hold on to the objects as long as you can. Like, for example, with the gravity gun in Half-Life 2. Because as soon as you grab it, as soon as it runs out of energy like that, it needs more time to recharge. Anyway, let's move further on. Yeah, that's a Vulgar here. And yes, he looks a bit like Accelerate from Ben 10, but without like the demonic looks. I know Accelerate has like a visor to cover his face when he's running at high speed. Like in the original series, I remember. Oh no, I'll try it again! Luckily, this is a single one at the moment. It's him gone for good. There's that portal right over there. I believe this is what Dr. Myers was on about in that teleportation experiment video that he was explaining in the Lost Mission. He said it was non-functional. We encounter a boss.
Welcome to your guest.
There's the Forgotten Ones coming out of that portal. Oh god. It's a Helltime Hunter. Ready? Now! Okay, all you have to do is you have to fire those plasma balls at at him. The other fireball fires one of those cannons instead of the ones he's firing. But they're no good with. Good when you're fighting against him. Using his own fireballs against him. Oh, I missed him! Be careful when fighting him! Oh, he nearly scratched me there. You can see here, he's actually using the distortion of time to be able to sip around the map at a very high speed. Don't know how many times you have to hit him. But check out my original Let's Play the Xbox version if you don't believe me. Oh, I can tell he doesn't like that. Wait for it. Oh, I missed him. What he's doing now. Oh! Nearly scratched me there. Well, I've been lucky. And one lucky devil. Yes! Got him!
Worthless human. This fight has only just begun.
Oh, has he powered up the artifact? Which we'll do later on.
Come in, Marine. Send a strength effect podcast. Now, listen carefully. This isn't the first time we're facing this, but I need your information. The artifact will cover this obviously capable of incredible power. May also be the source of this invasion. Do whatever it takes to get the artifact to me. I'll try to contact
the others. Oh, that ancient door. See, this looks different to what we saw in the Delta Labs. At least I was there before the Delta Labs teleporter was constructed. Well, that's a long way down there. No way I'm going in there. We're too soon to go into hell. Well, let's move to everyone, I'll show you what the artifact can really do. Thank you, autosave. I mean, that was just my dad coughing a bit. And also, I forgot to tell you that, you know, throughout the sometimes in February, we come out. Me and my mum came down with, like, diarrhea. Well, my mum with, but type 1 diabetes. Good thing my dad called her when she was down a bit in the bed. I thought she was going into a diabetic coma. And I, too, came also. Felt like severe diarrhea when I was sleeping. I can tell because of my uncontrolled body temperature and my increasing heart rate. I was nearly that close to vomiting. But the good thing was I was able to rest my body when I'm feeling sick. Yeah, it's almost like what my dad said, it was like a seeming casualty. Mind you, now that I think about it, I was thinking about one day having a guest appearance on the BBC show Casualty. You know, as like playing as a patient who can play as some lad who's suffering from like a severe diarrhea or being involved in an accident or a fight. Or, I don't know. Now you can see here when you're near a dead body, the artifact charges up. Now this is a bit where it gets really tricky. You can see these walls here that close rapidly. It's been a long time since I last did this. Boy, it's impossible to do this at a normal time speed. Have to wait for it. Wait for the right timing. Wait now! You can see here, you're able to move at a slow pace. Although you're moving at a fast pace, Joe, and you're slow, it's like you're slowing down time. I mean, you wouldn't expect me to go slow or fall in time in some goofy sports car or something. And again, I'm referencing Back to the Future, am I? Wait for it. And yeah, teach those security zombies a lesson. even at a slow time speed. There's some tablets again. There's the Guardian of Hell in these tablets. Like the ones we encountered in Doom 3 and the Lost Mission. Oh, now this is also tricky. Well, as soon as you take that power cell out, we only have like a few seconds to get across. See? You see how fast I reacted there? You have to be really quick to do this. Oh, don't worry. That's just my tripod case falling down. I mean...
Help, someone please!
What's going on? No! I've lost another one! Again, I was unable to save him! Unlike the other scientist I remember in Doom 3. I should have reloaded the pistol when I had the chance in that. Now you're wondering, now for the first time, you'll be wondering how to get past this door. Well, the answer is simple. Use the grabber! And drop those boxes down below. Oh, I could have sworn people would leave jackhammers lying around. And shovels. You're lucky I'm not using the gravel on you. Another Vulgar. And you can see here, he bears a resemblance to Accelerate.
Time to go nighty-night, Enoch.
That's what I remember from the show. Come on, Al, you coward. I bet you would see the stormtroopers doing this, you know, from Star Wars. Yeah, I think we're not going to use a grabber for the time being. Now, this looks kind of familiar. What the... Oh, God. Ah, luckily there's a help station right here. And so far, I haven't died in this... Oh no, how... Damn it! I was going to sneak up behind that imp while he was feasting on the body parts. But somehow he spotted me. Ah. Oh, another Vulgar. Vulgar, not Vulcan. Not like the Vulcan bombers. I believe that Marcus Tan's got a code for this locker. Let's have a look. Nope. Ah! See ya. 516. Oh, yeah. And who says I should snoop at other people's emails? Ah! Got it right. See how much grenades I've got. I've got 24 so far. Better save that medkit for when I need it. Huh. You really got blood upon that deal. That's not a good place to hide while you're fighting. Where's that other security zombie? Ah. I mean, what are we gonna have next? Security ninjas? I mean, come on. We've already had them in Rugrats in Paris. You! Well, that's what I get for not paying any attention. Didn't their mother ever tell them not to go near barrels? I'm an imp lock. Aha! Well, that nearly worked. It always works when an enemy's near the barrels. Like when we saw that security zombie. Oh, how did they even know where I was hiding? Must have good eyesight, him. He was having 10 eyes. That's something even a bee or a wasp would pick up. I mean, they have compound eyes. You know, like bees, wasps, and hornets, and flies, and possibly beetles. Oh, dang. Almost worked. Well, the good thing is I don't have any archbows lying about at the moment. In the meantime, I'll have a look at this guy. Oh god. A big trouble. Ah. There are two Vulgars and a forgotten one. That's double trouble. Or do I say triple trouble? Get this barrel away from me! Oh, close freaking call. I know. I was one step closer to dying. Should have just switched to the other weapon. It's way faster than reloading. This is like what I remember in the PC version of Resurrection of Evil. Oh yeah, you know the Xbox version of Resurrection of Evil was released in October 2005. And this game was also released early on in the year for the PC. Now the PC version of this game was like released as an expansion pack, or used as like, you know, an add-on pack for Doom 3. Which, that basically means that you need to have installed Doom 3 on the PC in order for it to run. Whereas in the case of the Xbox version, it was released as like a standalone product. If I remember rightly, it also includes Doom 2 and the master levels for Doom 2 in the Xbox version. Oh great, we got two more of them. Haha, again! And again, this always works when you're using barrels against enemies. There we go. Oh yeah, it's that power cell we took from down here. I think. Oh. Might be wrong. See, so yeah, status, offline, insufficient power. Oh yeah, we have to put that in here first. Ah, power's back online. But before we do that, I better get some health. I never know when I may need a health station. Uh-oh, we've got company. I wonder where they're going. Oh, I know what they're doing. Whoa! Wasn't expecting a Vulgar! Oh, he didn't even stand a chance! Oh, I was expecting him to, like, kiss the floor while he was dead. Come on, you can't kiss the floor if you're already dead! Okay, the grab is completely useless against him. Now what? Oh great, forgotten ones, again. More of them! They're gonna cause me real aggro again. And you're not supposed to open doors! They're like, just like the Lost Souls in classic Doom. Gosh. Oof. Ouch! Oh. That takes care of them. No, that reminds me again. Before we head any further, I need more health. You know, before we continue further on. We have to go back here again. Oh, thank goodness for that. And I've got 24% of armor, which doesn't really matter for the time being. Doing so well right here, and I haven't died in once in this Wii Let's Play. And you know, unfortunately, like always, I will have to cut off here. So I will see you next time as we go through the Erebus Labs. And until then, bye.